Wandering Souls with a new collection update. Different kind of stuff today, all CDs, but different kind of genres. I'll see how it goes. I don't feel in the best condition, let's put it that way. I feel a bit, if I have something in me that says you're gonna be sick soon, but I hope not that will happen, but we'll see. Just try my best, and if you see something other in other clothes and stuff, a newer part in the video, then you know what's up. Then I stopped filming and added something later into the video. Hopefully it works today. We'll see how I feel. There are some tunes on the background. This is a Left Hand Solution with Fevered, some doom metal from Sweden, female fronted, great stuff. I talked about this in another update, so I'm not gonna make too many words on this. Yeah, good stuff. This first thing is a freebie I got from Dawnbreed Records. I hope you can remember that vinyl video that I talked about, that I missed some sleeve and got some stuff extra to make it up. That's really why this is one of those things. This is Phantasmagore with Insurrection or Submission. And there's some filthy, nasty death metal from Chile. Good stuff. You like things like Old Incantation, that kind of old school vein, death metal, kind of murky stuff. Some Finnish influences as well. Has faster moments, and of course also that doomy moments like a band like Incantation has, and there's definitely some great stuff here. Heavy deep vocals, but not too muffled, you can hear what he's singing, but yeah, they are deep, and yeah, really good stuff. I really was really enjoying this, and I'm glad I've got this from Dawnbreed Records. So Jeff, thank you very much for this. There are some stuff, of course this is released on Dawnbreed Records, that's why it is easy to give something, but yeah, really cool stuff. I heard this name from this band a lot, and the VC, especially in extreme metal music videos, but never owns anything, and thanks to Jeff I own now something from these guys, so it's really cool. Phantasmagore with Insurrection or Submission, great stuff. Then I've got here the new Ahab with the Coral Tombs, I think it's called, yeah, the Coral Tombs. Fantastic funeral doom from Germany. They call it Nautic doom because they have all kind of Nemo undersea themes to their lyrics. Really interesting, really fantastic stuff. Look at that artwork, fantastic stuff here. Really nice GG pack. Yeah, slow doom metal, has kind of melodic moments as well, some clean vocals as well, also the heavy growls. Yeah, fantastic stuff. I think this is the first release they did on Napalm Records, if I'm correct. If I'm incorrect, tell me also. But it seems to be that Napalm Records is picking up a lot of bands lately. This is also on that label. But fantastic band. This is, can't recall how much they, I think they have released 4 albums. Could be mistaken there. There are some people out there that know that are really good. I think Ron Haggerty or something will know this. Fantastic funeral doom, definitely worth looking into if you like slow, mournful doom metal, growl vocals and clean vocals, then you will enjoy this. Really good stuff. Go check it out, Ahab with the Coral Tombs, and 2023 release as well, so brand new. Good stuff. I also picked up the new Venom Prison. This is Erebus. This was released at the end of last year. Fantastic death metal from the UK. There's some gory moments as well, but overall this is fantastic death metal. Female fronted as well. great voice, kind of screamy in places as well, also can growl like a beast, really good band. This is the second release I own from this band, and I'm really happy to own this one. Really good stuff, released on Central Media, so it's easy to get everywhere in the world. So, great band, check out Venom Prison with Aerobus. I hope I'm not going too fast, but we'll see. Mart, I have a pretty decent stack here, so we'll see how far I come. Next up, let's see, two releases I picked up online, two releases from JPU Records, I think, but I ordered them somewhere else, if I'm not mistaken. First one is Nemophila with Oiran, and this is the extended edition. Awesome band, kind of a modern metal band, kind of metalcore-ish. But also have other influences in here. Fantastic band, of course, all female. Oiran, fantastic track. I really like Raitai. Sorai was fantastic. Dissension, yeah, awesome stuff here. Clean vocals and harsher vocals. I hope you guys can see that because, yeah, there it is. That's the back. Great band. Let's see if there's a picture from the girls. Yes, there it is. Here are the girls. Japanese band, and fantastic. I really enjoy these girls' music. Yeah, did some reaction videos to their songs as well. And I decided just to pick up some material from them, and I'm really glad to have this in the collection. This was released in 2021, I think. Yeah, 2021. Awesome stuff, Oiran by Nemophila. Also picked up the last release from Mary's Blood, which is this one. Again, a Japanese all-female band, but this is more heavy metal, power metal stuff, and more a clean vocal. Really good stuff, great bands, great melodies, great riffs. Fast pumping where it needs to be, and slow down where it needs to. I've enjoyed this, listening to this, and yeah, fantastic stuff. I discovered this also through YouTube and other people talking about it, and decided to pick this CD up. I think it's the last one they released. I heard some things that they quit or something like that, so it's kind of a shame. They were a pretty decent band, and hopefully these girls will appear in other bands. That would be fantastic. Mary's Blood. If you're not familiar with these girls, go check them out. Really good heavy power metal from Japan. Let's see what we have here next. This is the new one from Tersai the Horder. This is I can read that because of these I am your enemy can be the first part. It's kind of not just a tint of dark here. And one of these I am your enemy, that's the title. You see here the title track. Three tracks, long tracks, post black metal on Consoling Sounds. Great label. The Side Order is a band I really enjoy. They're from Utrecht, the Netherlands, and this is I think the second or third release I have from these guys, I think. And I really enjoy this. This is the newest one, released last year, I think, at the end of last year. I don't recall, otherwise it's 2023. I don't know, but I will put it in the description. Fantastic album, I really love it. Dust Where the Dust, the great atmosphere, nasty vocals, really scratchy. Really, really good stuff, great riffing. Fantastic black metal here. I really enjoy the artwork, looks phenomenal. Great stuff. Third album from these guys, and glad to own it. fantastic band. Terzai de Horde, remember that name. Of course, I will mention all these bands in the description, so you can look it up if you are interested in one of those albums or multiple. I'll see that one. That by the DLC. I also picked up a new one from Omnium Gatherum, and this is Origin. It's also in 2020. Is it 2021? 2022? I don't know. Somewhere like that. The album I looked over, I have seen it that it was out, but I never dived into this. It's a Finnish melodic death metal, sorry. Good stuff, but somehow I need to spin this a bit more. It didn't regret me entirely yet, but it will someday, because the riff and the melodies are great, but I just need to land a bit more. I just need to give it more spins, but there's so much stuff to listen to. But someday I will come to this back again and see if it clicks. I really enjoy the art reveal, the skeletons there, also awesome looking. At least on social media, once again, that label also releases a lot of stuff. There are a couple of labels here in the metal community that are doing great things. Yeah, great bands, but like I said, it needs to land a bit more. Onion Gatherer, its Origin. I also picked up the second reissue of Invocator, and this is Weave the Apocalypse, their second album. Again, and another Hammerheart reissue with a bonus disc. I picked up the first one, which was more technical death thrash, but also had more death metal elements. This one seems to tend a bit more to the thrash side, and the vocals are a bit less guttural, let's put it that way. And interesting stuff. I have to be honest that I like the first album a bit more than this one, but this is not really bad at all. Fantastic thrash, great technical riffing. Bonus CD with a ton of tracks, a promo. Let's see, there are some live footage on here and some covers. So the CDs are filled with material here. Sorry. Let's look at it without the slipcase here. And it looks like this. Nice double disc set. Hammerheart does a great job with their reissues. Thick booklet as well, but I'm not gonna take out all the booklets today. Like I said, I don't feel like stretching the video are necessary because I don't feel so well. But yeah, good stuff. Yeah, Invocator with Leave the Apocalypse, their second album. Again, another reissue on Hammerheart Records. Go pick it up if you haven't heard it yet and you like some technical thrash, then this is up your alley. They're from Denmark, I think. Great band. And then another, this is a Central Media reissue, but I think Hammerheart has also reissued this back in the day. And this is Necrophobic with Rintursen. Always have trouble pronouncing that name. But this is a fantastic album, a really overlooked album from this Swedish band. Great riffing, melodic, freshy, blacky, death metal. Great stuff. Really can recommend you if you like that melodic black death things. Go check this band out. This is a really nice reissue. It was about time that this was the issue, because a lot of people were looking for it, because original copies were sold out already. So it came in handy. And this reissue, of course, was way cheaper than the originals on Discogs, so I'm glad to have it in the collection. I just need a couple more albums and I'm quiet, okay with this band. I have a lot of releases from these guys. I love their work. Great band. Rittersum by Necrophobic. And again, I probably butchered that, but who cares? Also,
also picked up the new Hell Ripper, Warlocks, Grim and Withered Hags. Fantastic black and thrash speed metal. This is definitely the best effort so far. Great riffing, fantastic vocals, catchy hooks in this. I really enjoyed listening to this album. This was just an album that I put on and put on repeat and repeat. Fantastic riffing, like I said. Really good stuff. Great 2023 release. Third album, I think. Great bands. Released on Peace of Ville Records. Also a decent label. But yeah, if you like you think like Midnight and you know that kind of bands, then you will enjoy this. Great stuff. Great black and speed thrash metal. I think they're from Scotland, if I'm not mistaken. And a lot of people in the VC were talking about back in the day about this band, and it just dots me out the region because it's some fantastic stuff. One man project. Kind of surprising, but it sounds really good. So go check it out. Hell Ripper with the new one, Warlocks, Grim and Withered Hags. Great album. Then another 2023 release. This is Catatonia with The Sky Void of Stars. Is this one called? This is the newest album, 2023 release. Swedish band, dark rock band, kind of a progressive edge to it. This is a sound they have already since years, and they're not changing their path. The band started out as a death doom band, but developed more halfway the 90s to what it is today. And this has nothing to do with metal, in my opinion, but it's a really, really great band. Great vocals, great atmosphere. And this is just a really nice band to chill out to, in my opinion. Great riffing, great melodies. And the vocals, Jonas Renske, are fantastic. Great band, definitely one album to look into. Also a Napalm Records release. There it is. So, like I said, they're doing a great job here. Catatonia with the Sky Void of Stars. Go check it out. Complete first here. But hope you guys don't mind. Like I said, I don't want to stretch the video too long. Then the last three are things I picked up from New Era Productions. One reissue and two new albums. Start off with the reissue. This is Graveland with Thousand Swords. Polish black metal. You all guys know this kind of epic feel to their music. This is definitely more the old sound. The newer sound got more folky, although there are already some elements in there of their changing. This was released in 95 original, and after that they changed style more. So this is kind of a hybrid to the old days and the more newer days. The sound definitely lies a bit more in the old days, but like I said, it has something with the new days as well. Kind of epic majestic feel about the music. Really nice reissue. This is done by No Colors, I think. Probably No Color Records. Really nice booklet as well, with all nice action pictures of Rob Darken and the other member in action with the swords, and you know, I really like this kind of imaging. Kind of cringy in a way, but still I really like it. Also, images in the forest are always good with me. Yeah, of course, in the black and white style, you know, the black metal style, let's keep it grim. So, good stuff, Graveland with Thousand Swords. Really nice reissue. Then I'll pick up the new Satanic War Master. This is Amon Gandor. Fantastic Finnish black metal. It's definitely how Finnish black metal should sound. Great riffing, great melodies, great atmosphere, nasty, raspy vocals. Really like it. Great stuff. Of course, Werewolf is the main man. He's also the man behind Werewolf Records, where this was released on. Yeah, fantastic album, new release. Of course, we got a preview last year with the single Baphomet, which is the first track on this album, and already kind of gave a forebode of what's to come. And the tracks after this are even better than that track. So definitely look into this album. Great atmosphere, great keyboard work, great guitar riffs. Yeah, this band always has a riff for days. Fantastic stuff, great drum work. Nothing wrong with this, and I really enjoy the artwork here. Fantastic looking artwork. I have a picture here, and it's behind this. Nice pentagram. So yeah, the new Satanic War Mass, a long-running band. If you are into the Black Metal Underground, then you will came across this someday. God, this band has had so many releases. Yeah, you can't miss that. Great band, Satanic War Mass, Master with Among Gander. Their new album, 2023 release. And then the last one is kind of a sketchy one. Sketchy, yes. This is on NSBM, so if you don't like that kind of stuff, turn away, pause, end the video, and go do something else if you are offended by that. Let's make one thing clear: I am not supporting the ideology of the NSBM world, but there are some album music-wise that sounds fantastic. Without paying any attention to the lyrics, I think lately they are not focusing on the national socialistic side. I think if I see where all the songs are about, lately they're a bit less than in the past. But nonetheless, the band has, especially the leader of this band, Black Goat, has of course that connection to that world. Finnish band. Goat Moon, like I said, this is the new release. Whatever was shall be again, and this is was released last year, first on tape, and finally in 2023 there is a CD version. I think in the summer there will be a vinyl version as well from this album. Unless you don't get you off guard with the NS team, because if you look at the track listing, I don't see anything that points out that direction. The lyrics are not in here as well, so you can't make that out clearly here. But this is fantastic black metal, just like Satanic War Master one. This is definitely music you will enjoy if you like some great riffing black metal with kind of a folky touch to it as well. It's really, really good stuff. I really like the vocal, it's really nasty, raspy vocal, fast drumming. Nice riffs, great keyboard work as well to create that atmosphere on this album. Yeah, I really enjoy this album, and like I said, I am not supporting the ideology that doesn't appeal to me and just in here for the music. And I'm not a really big NSBM collector anyways. I just have some albums that just appeared to be NSBM, let's put it that way. I think I have an old album from Nocturnal Mortem, Near Christ, that's really considered NSBM. I have to work after that, it's totally different, it has and doesn't have anything to do with it. And this is also a kind of band, it's not prominent out there preaching, you know, the Nazis and whatever, it's not like that. Like I said, they have the ideology, but they don't put it. Of course, there will be moments that they have think, well, yeah, this kind of point of view that you think that fits to that, but it's not like that pitchy stuff, anyways. But like I said, I'm in here for the music, and the music is fantastic, guys. Just look it up and listen to it, and. I don't think if you are against that ideology and you don't want anything to do with that, that's fine with me as well. Each to his own, you know. And like I said, I'm not a person that seeks out this stuff continuously. I have a few albums, I have a few old ones from this band. So I had the Near Christ album, Nocturnal Mortem, and that's probably the only thing I have in my collection from that kind of stuff. Some people say Graveland, a Nazi band, but I've never found any proof that they are. So it's always put somewhere, you know, it's not a political band. Yeah, and of course Burzum, but you know, the music of Burzum has nothing political in it. It's just only religion and darkness and stuff like that. This has nothing to do with politics anyway. Although Vark has his own opinions about things, but I don't support, I don't share that ideology. So yeah, kind of sketchy, but I just wanted to put this in here because I just wanted to show this album, because music wise this is a fantastic album and could appeal to more black metal lovers and then out there that, you know, are willing to put aside that ideology. It's all up to you. If you don't want to buy this, it's fine with me as well. So Gold Boom, but was once was, shall be again. Great, fantastic album. Go check it out. Great, great black metal from Finland. So that's it, guys. Still 26, 27 minutes, somewhere in that vein. Yeah, I've pulled through pretty quick, but just like I said, I felt better the last couple of days than I feel today. I just wanted to film this video, otherwise the stack of new stuff will be too huge to talk about, and then the videos will be fucking long. So just want to put it out here. I will, like I said, I will put the names in the description so you can check the bands out if you want to, and let me know in the comment section down below how you feel about certain things. Yeah, I don't want to start a politic discussion here. If you want to do that, yeah, it's not to me, but I'm not here for the politics, guys. I'm just here for the music, and yeah, each to his own, each to his own opinion. And if you have respect for each other, then you come along, come along, or go along nicely, I think. So thank you all for watching, guys. Really appreciate it. Thank you all for your support. If you put off buying this one record for my channel, sorry. But like I said, I'm not heavy collecting into this NSBM things. I just happen to be one release in there that is that stuff. Excuse me. So thank you, and I hope to see you guys with the next video. Thank you, take care, and hope you are feeling better than I do. Cheers.